Imagine creating product listings in half the time with better accuracy and improved discoverability across multiple sales channels. Sounds too good to be true, right? Well, that's exactly what Shopify's new standard product taxonomy promises. So let's break it down. In the past year, we've helped over 250 clothing brands boost their success, adding more than $10 million in extra revenue. We achieved this through top-notch website optimization, smart ad strategies, and powerful email marketing. If you're new here, I'm Christian Pignon. My business partner is Aaron Pearson, and we release two new videos every week. Aaron dives deep into marketing strategies while I focus on mastering Shopify and perfecting your brand's design. So what is Shopify's standard product taxonomy? So think of it as a massive smart library of product data. It actually covers over 26 different business verticals, and it maps more than 10,000 product categories and includes over 1,000 associated product attributes. In simpler terms, it's a standardized way to classify and describe your products that makes sense across the entire e-commerce ecosystem. So we're talking about, you know, standardizing the way that people now, for example, build t-shirts on Shopify, on TikTok, on Google, on Facebook, on any platform, on the Shop app. Now everything is going to, I think, make a little bit more sense, and it's going to be structured in a way that is very similar from one clothing store to the other. Now, I did want to show you just a quick example, more of a visual, right, of what we're looking at here. So this right here is the GitHub product taxonomy, basically. This is the latest release. And as you can see, it goes by different categories or different levels. So if we go into level one, which is apparel and accessories, we click on it, and then we get level two, right? From there, it's actually clothing. And then from there, we go to level three, which is, let's say it's a clothing top. And then from the clothing top, let's say that it's an actual blouse. So now we've categorized this particular product, right, that we have. It's a clothing top, it's a blouse. And as you can see right here on the right-hand side, you'll get these category attributes. So this is exactly what Shopify has done in order to make it the same from one clothing store using a blouse to the other. Now, as you can see here, we have age group, we have clothing features, color, fabric, neckline, pattern, size, sleeve length type, target gender, top length type. So it will automatically give you these categories. Now you choose, right, whether or not you want to use them or not. But as you can see, it's going to be now moving forward, it's going to be the exact same from one store to the other. Now, how does it work? Let's say that you're selling a kitchen chair, and in the past you have to manually input all the details like size, color, material, etc. Now, Shopify's AI powered system will automatically suggest the most appropriate category for your product. So just like we just did here with this example, right, where like we're actually picking the categories and whatnot, you'll be able to just very easily see these category attributes right away. So in this case, for example, it might classify it as furniture, chairs, kitchen and dining room chairs, right? Once categorized, the system will automatically suggest relevant attributes for that specific type of product. So there's no more guessing, right, what information you should include about this particular product. Shopify is going to sort of give you the answers right away. And I mean, I don't want to do all these, right? But you also got to think about the customer's mind. What's going to be the most helpful for the customer to have in terms of some of this information? And you got to think about, in the future, you'll be able to use this category attribute to display, for example, on things like Google. So someone on Google, going back to the blouse example, if someone on Google is looking for a blouse that's made out of silk and it's purple, and you have the right attributes in here and you've assigned them to this particular product, then all those attributes will sort of connect with Google, right? And give those people the exact same, the exact product that you have on your store. Now, if we go to our test store here and I go into add a new product, I can show you exactly how this looks. So let's grab this title of this product here and type it in here. Let's also grab this description of the product, and we're gonna paste it right within here. Okay, and then we have a couple of images. Let's upload those images. Price was $98. As you can see, Shopify, because of what I'm typing into the title and description of this particular product, it starts to automatically categorize this product for me. So as we can see in here, we have 8 meta fields that are being suggested to me. In the actual category, we have hoodies and activewear, sweatshirts and hoodies. So if we click on that, we'll see that yes, it is a hoodie. And then the next thing that we can click on is the actual suggested meta fields. So once we click on that, it will scroll you down to the new category meta fields. Now, it could be a little bit confusing because we're talking about product attributes. We're also talking about category meta fields. We're talking about product taxonomy. So a lot of, I would say, interchangeable words. I think at the end of the day, what you're going to see in the back end for your store is going to be this right here, category meta fields. And just like they are, they're just different categories, you know, to dive a little bit deeper into what the product actually is. So the purple ones means that these are being suggested by Shopify because of the information that I've given Shopify. So that's one of the best things that we have right now, right? It's AI powered, where it's automatically recognizing all the keywords that I've used within the description and the title of the product and using those actual keywords into these category meta fields and actually assigning the actual attribute for that particular category. So we'll see color, we'll see green in here, size, extra small, small, medium, large, extra large. It grabbed the sizing because I think I have it in here. Models were in an extra small. So I have a little bit of information on the sizing. So it automatically assumed, right, that I had the extra small all the way up to extra large, which is kind of cool. The activewear clothing features. So it actually grabbed that from the description of the product. It's a long sleeve, target gender, and knows that it's for females. So again, it's automatically doing all this. It's automatically categorizing, automatically recognizing that it's a hoodie, that it has all these features. And not only that, you know, we can include these categories, but what actually goes into each of these categories. Now, once you click on the purple, which I would say those are the AI recommended attributes, you can actually click on it and make any changes that you need to make, right? When it's purple like that, like I said, it's suggested, but if you need to make any changes to this, as you think this is actually more unisex, then you can change it to unisex. But that's really all you need to do here is just review some of the information that Shopify is giving you right here. And this is where things actually, to me, get really exciting, because these are product attributes, right? These are standardized pieces of information about your product that now other clothing stores are also going to have this sort of standardized way of showing and displaying some of this information. So going back to like our kitchen chair example, so it's gonna include like the color, the seat type, the chair features, right? So the best part is like a lot of these are gonna be pre-populated based on your product category, based on the description that you've already typed. So it's gonna save you a lot of time. And it's also going to ensure that you have consistency across your store and across different sales channels. So to me, like, yeah, this is very exciting because, yes, stores are going to be more consistent within their own ecosystem, but then also expanding into other things like TikTok and Google, you're also going to be consistent on those platforms, comparing yourself, right, to other brands out there. Like I said, the cool thing about this too is that it's AI powered. So they're using Shopify magic. So anytime you see that purple, that means that they're using Shopify magic. So they're using the AI algorithm and they're analyzing product name, description, images, and they're basically giving you the right categories. They're pre-filling a lot of the attribute values right there for you. So you don't have to do a lot of digging or you have to do a lot of copy and pasting right into this. It's just a matter of reviewing some of this information. So I do want to give you another example of maybe you already have some products in your store and you're wondering like, well, is the AI going to work exactly the same? Unfortunately, it may not be as seamless as adding a new product. So as you can see, we have this old product in here. It has images, it has pictures. It does give you automatically the color and the fabric. So those two things are already in here as part of category meta fields. Now, it hasn't necessarily recognized exactly what this item is. It's just having it in a very general clothing area. So if you actually go in and categorize it a little bit further, then it's gonna expand the amount of category meta fields that you have. So in here we have a jumpsuit. So if we go in here, so for the purpose of this example, if we just type in clothing tops instead of just clothing, so we're diving a little bit deeper, right, into those levels that we showed earlier. Now you can see like we have more category meta fields, but unfortunately it doesn't use AI for these already pre-existing products. So you will have to type in some of this information manually in here. So if you have a lot of existing products, then the process may be a little bit more manual than it would be if you were adding brand new products. But moving forward, it's gonna be a lot easier. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, please consider hitting that like button. We release new videos every week. Now, another reason, if you don't have enough reasons so far to make sure that you're doing these new category meta fields on your store, it's that this new way of doing category meta fields for color is going to give you a native support for swatches. So if you're using the most recent version of Shopify themes, their free version like Dawn and Trade, etc., you'll automatically get color swatches on your product pages now with no extra coding required. which is pretty awesome. So let's recap. Benefits: it's gonna streamline your product creation. So it's gonna actually create listings faster and more accurately. Number two, your customers are gonna be able to discover your products a little bit better, right? You're gonna improve your on-site search. You're gonna make it easier for customers to find what they're looking for, especially when they're looking through filters and different things like that. You'll be able to use these category meta fields for your filters. And number three, you're gonna seamlessly list your products on platforms like Google and Instagram, again, with standardized data. So it's gonna be a lot cleaner. It's gonna be a lot easier for your customers to find exactly what they're looking for. Now, if you're interested in learning how to do color swatches now with the new product taxonomy feature, then comment down below color swatches and we're gonna make a video for you, but if you comment down below, we'll make it a little bit faster for you on exactly how to take advantage of these color swatches with this new product taxonomy feature. So comment down below. And if you're new here, or maybe you've been here for a little bit and you're excited about this new feature and you wanna learn all about maybe some new additional features and things that Shopify has released, and you definitely want to check out this video next, where we go an overview into Shopify Editions Summer 24. See you there.